Hello everyone, welcome back. This is Roshni. How are you doing? I hope you are doing great. So today is the second day of our series and I am here to share 5 power packed words with you. So the first word for today is not a very happy one. It happens, mostly we share our happy experiences, happy moments, jubilant moments, but we rarely talk about our sad moments. So while describing our sad moments, instead of saying I was sad, you can say I was agonized. Yes, the first word for today is agonize. It's agonize. Agonize means extreme pain, tremendous grief, torture, worry. Yeah, so there are so many sentences, so many places where you can use this word. For an example, while describing a sentence like, the increasing number of patients from coronavirus makes me feel agonized. You can also use this word while describing a sentence like, it was an agonizing moment for me when I caught up an accident. I hope it is clear to you. Now moving forward, the second word for today is bedazzle. Yes, bedazzle. The past form of bedazzle is bedazzled. Yes, but the original, the normal form is bedazzled. It is used when you are describing something which has obstructed you. Like you are captivated by the beauty of it. For an example, you can say the audience was bedazzled by her performance. Yes. So you can also use these words like the lake, the concert, the garden, the lights of the hotel bedazzled me. Okay, like again some more examples if I want to give, it can be like I was bedazzled by the painting of Mona Lisa. Yes, bedazzled. Now let's move on to our next word. The next word for today is muddled. Muddled. Muddled basically means mixed up, perplexed, confused. You can use this word while describing sentences like, I got muddled while solving mathematic problems. The second example you can take of a normal situation, you know, whenever a girl needs to go out, whenever a girl need to go out for an outing or to attend any party, the first thing she has to do is to open her wardrobe. And yes, whenever she opens her wardrobe, she gets muddled. Yes, she gets muddled. She gets muddled to choose the right outfit for her the day. I hope it's very clear to you. Now moving forward, the next word is vivacious. Yes, vivacious. This is my favorite one. I just love this word. Is vivacious. Vivacious basically means vibrant, lively, bubbly, very light-hearted, full of life, spirited. Well, you can use it in sentences like, she decided to change herself and become a vivacious after she got recovered from her depression. The next example we can take as, I love her company because she has such a vivacious and elegant personality. So I hope it's very clear to you. Vivacious, please keep on using this word for in your vocabulary. It's a very awesome word. So the last word for today is a very interesting one. Yes, it's obtuse. It basically means dumb or unintelligent. You may have heard this word in geometry. An acute angle and obtuse angle. So obtuse angle mean an angle which is greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree, and an acute angle is a sharp angle which is less than 90 degree. So acute as a word is used to denote sharp, and therefore it is used as mentally sharp. And obtuse as a word is used to denote blunt. So therefore we can also say a little slow in mind. For an example, we can say the man was so obtuse that he gave all his ID and password to a fake caller. Another example we can take, a situation in your daily life. like your friend, your spouse, your brother, your sister, anyone is angry with you and you don't know why. So you may say them, maybe I'm obtuse, but I don't know why are you upset with me. If you like my videos, then please give a thumbs up to me and subscribe my channel. Thank you. God bless you.